Welcome back to Appliance Educator. Today we have a pretty fun episode planned for you. It's a little DIY, kind of getting away from appliances. Before I let Nick take it away to tell you what we're doing, I just want to point out, look at Nick, his plants. He's a very proud plant dad. We just did a podcast on plants recently on herbology, and so check that out on our channel. But I just want to take a moment and look at this. Before we begin, we're going to take this away. But yeah, Nick, if you want to tell us what we're going to be doing today.
Yeah, so we're at my house today, and we have partnered with a great new company called Renoboard. And this is a product that seems to be very easy to use. And I'll give you a little sample here. No, actually, that's just the cardboard packaging mat. This right here is Renoboard. It's very thin, as you can see, and it's got the foam already attached to it. And it is a peel and stick here. And we will be peeling and sticking to my wall here. So there are a few steps to prep the wall here. We are going to sand it down, sand down the texture to pretty much the drywall so it's a nice smooth finish, and that way the glue will stick properly to the wall. And we'll, after we sand it, we've got to make sure we wipe it and clean it very well too, because you don't want those dust particles from the sanding still on there, because that will not let the glue adhesive work as well either. So let's get my babies out of the way and get some prep going, huh, Matt?
Let's do it.
I like your hair dye.
Huh?
I like your hair dye.
Oh, thanks.
So, we sanded down basically the entire wall. There's no more texture. It's pretty smooth, almost down to basically just the original drywall, or the boards itself. Now all I have to do is we're gonna vacuum this, we're gonna wipe it down to get all the dust off. Just to reiterate what Roger said earlier, is the reason we sanded down the texture is so that the glue wouldn't get air around the texture and it would just dry out and eventually fall off. This way it has a nice, soft, solid surface to stick to.
Nice and flat.
Nice and flat, exactly. We did, as you can tell, had a work cut out for us.
Made a bit of a mess.
Made a bit of a mess, yep.
Girlfriend's not happy.
Yep.
But she'll love the wall.
She will love the wall. So now we're gonna wipe this down and then we're gonna get to cutting the boards and just basically peeling and sticking them.
So we're going to use just water and a rag, lightly with the water. You don't want too much water to absorb into the boards.
Yep. All right. Let's get started. Well, we've definitely had our work cut out for us.
Yep.
You can tell because of the way Nick's hair is. So the hardest part was really cutting around this outlet here.
Getting these pieces here and here.
Yes, to make it look sense. But it's already looking pretty darn good. I mean, look at how that's already looking. Take a step back. It's going to be a nice little accent wall. And I mean, it really beats the hell out of using like a table saw to cut wood flooring.
We're,
that you put
we're
on
literally
there.
Cutting this with a pocket knife.
Yep. Pocket knife or scissors, depending on the cut. This outlet here and this light switch, we'll probably use the X-Acto knife, just is more accurate, but for the rest of it, scissors will do the job just nicely.
All right, well, that was a task for sure. It looks pretty good though. Looks like it's gonna come in. There are some finishing touches that I will do with these little cracks here. But for the most part, I think it's gonna do well and, you know, it looks great. So yeah, stay tuned for more Appliance Educator. If you like this video, follow us, subscribe, like, comment, all the above. And remember, renoboard.com for to get your peel and stick walls. I think it looks great. Now the real work begins, cleaning this place up.